already shuffled. And we'll be taking a look at the recent past energy. Between you and your person, we'll find out what's coming up. We'll take a look and see what the challenge is going to be, and then we'll find out what the outcome is. So, Gemini, the recent past energy between you and your person. Well, we got the Knight of Swords, and it's with the Eight of Pentacles. Now, the Knight of Swords, it is actually a fairly upbeat and cheerful type of energy. It can often mean that someone or something desirable is about to seek you out. It points to physical and emotional energy being at a peak. So if you're waiting on news from someone or something, you'll like what you hear when you get the Knight of Swords in a reading. Now, the Knight of Swords, it can point to lots of activity, travel, being out and about, getting things accomplished. The Knight of Swords is not likely to feel like waiting for anything to come to them, so that's actually a good thing. The Knight of Swords goes after their heart's desire. Now, it's with the Eight of Pentacles, which points to necessary effort. You could have a lot on your plate that you need to accomplish. Dedication to the task is actually important, but if you let it work for its own sake, just know that it can be counterproductive. So be clear on what you're trying to accomplish and strive for balance. And I say this because no one should or can work all the time, but the Eight of Pentacles, it does indicate a very hard work period. Now, this does not have to be negative, but you do have to be prepared for it. Yeah. So, Gemini, recent past energy, Knight of Swords, clarified by the Eight of Pentacles. So, what I'm picking up is that you and your person, the person that you're dealing with, I'm getting that your person was always putting in a lot of work, effort, and energy into being with you, or for you two to come together. For some of you, your person lived or lives long distance, and it took a lot of effort. It took a lot of energy and work. Just to come towards you. That's why I'm picking up that your person was long distance. And they had to travel for the two of you to be together. But for those of you who are not long distance, it's just indicating that your person was always excited to be with you. This person will cut out anything that got in their way just to come towards you. Or to be with you, they probably enjoyed sweeping you off your feet. That's what the Knight of Swords does. This person takes action. And even if they were busy, like this Eight of Pentacles, they always made time for you and the connection. So it's a pretty good energy in the recent past with you and your person. But let's move on over. Let's take a look and see what's coming up for the two of you. Okay, so we got the Emperor. And it's with justice. Now, the Emperor shows that domination over the mind, over the heart, is sometimes necessary, even though it's not wanted. In fact, it should be welcomed, and that's what you must think about when this card appears. Because when hard choices have to be made, it's important to maintain your concentration, maintain your focus. Well, the Emperor signals this, but he also signals that now is a time you'll find it easier to make hard choices. So enjoy the assertiveness, enjoy the confidence that this self-control and focus brings. Forge ahead, do what you know is best, because I say this because if you can master yourself, then you'll have very little problems mastering most of the other obstacles that life can throw at you. Now, it's with justice. Justice actually deals with the idea of karma and the law of cause and effect. So, it's important to remember that not everything you're dealing with is a direct result of your own actions or your own karma. Because sometimes we're actually called upon to deal with the results of the actions of someone we care about. So keep that in mind and don't blame yourself unnecessarily. Also, when you get justice, if you're directly involved in a court case, it's likely to be at least a large degree resolved in your favor. So, coming up, Emperor clarified by justice. So the message I'm getting is that, yeah, your person, they, like I said, they like coming towards you. They enjoy being with you. They usually will cut out whatever it takes just to be in your presence, Gemini, but with this Emperor here, the Emperor is a very, very cold type of energy. It's a card above the word present. The Emperor does not open up their heart. The Emperor does not want to come across as being vulnerable. The Emperor can be a leader, boss, really arrogant, very shut off, unemotional type of energy. And when your person comes towards you, this time you could feel like you want to turn into the Emperor. Yeah, and because it's with justice, some of you could be feeling that there's some type of wrong that your person did, or how they made you feel in some type of they made you feel some type of way that's making you feel some wrong was done, some injustice was done towards you or towards the connection, and you feel like it needs to be made right. They need to come correct. They need to clean it up. They need to fix it. So, I'm picking up that, yeah, you want some type of wrong to be made right. You want justice to be served. Maybe a person said or did something you didn't like or appreciate, and you feel like you're gonna go cold on this person. You're not feeling warm. You're not feeling that you're going to be your usual warm self when you two come together. You're going to feel like shutting down. Very cold energy. Yeah, you're not happy about something that they did, something that they said, and you want them to fix it. You want justice to be served. You want that wrong to be made right. So you're shutting down coming up, Gemini. But let's move on over. Let's take a look and see what the challenge is. So we have the Three of Cups, and it's with judgment. Now, the Three of Cups is considered to be a card of reunions. It can be the type of reunion in the broadest sense of running back into or meeting up with someone purposefully, or maybe someone that you've been away from for some time. Now, this is considered to be a happy reunion, very upbeat. It can also mean celebration, your own or someone that you care about, maybe celebrating around a new baby, a wedding, or some type of happy occasion. Now, it's with judgment, which is a card about jumping to conclusions, decisions, and of course, judgments that are made too hastily. So if you're prone to doing such things, it's actually a sign that you just might need to slow down, give things more thought, give people more chances. This can also be a time of spiritual awakening. It can also be a time when the connection is at a make or break. Make or break, period. So coming up, Gemini, Three of Cups, clarified by judgment. So like I said, your person, they like being with you. They enjoy your company. This person, they have emotions for you. But you're deciding to, or you can't help but to go cold on them. But they want to come towards you. And with the Three of Cups here, they want it to be good, like it's been. They want to rejoice with you. They want the happiness that they've always felt with you. They want the two of you to celebrate. Maybe continuing celebrating the new year. Or celebrate the new year if you two haven't been together since 2021. But they can feel your judgment. Yeah, they feel your judgment. They could be thinking that you're jumping to conclusions. You're making decisions too fast. Or you're just not offering any type of forgiveness. Yeah, but they want to come together and celebrate with you. And they're hoping that things are just as good as they've always been, but you're shutting down. You want something to be made right. You feel like they did you wrong in some kind of way. Or you're just starting to feel some kind of way about something that happened, or something they said, or something that they did. So you shut down. You go cold like the Emperor. That's what a lot of you are doing. That's what's showing, that's coming up for the two of you. But let's move on over. Let's see what the outcome is. Now we got to Five of Pentacles, and we got the Ten of Swords. Now the Five of Pentacles actually points to a time when life is feeling less than secure. But the important thing to remember is that there's always help available when we need it from forces seen and unseen. You could start to feel alone, but just know you have the capacity to change that if you reach out. You could feel left out in the cold, as though everyone in the world has everything, and you're the only one suffering. Realize this is not the case, so do the best that you can with what you have. But remember, the wise thing to do is, if you need help, is to just go out and ask for it, because the help that you need, it will come. Now, it's over the Ten of Swords, which is a sign to be careful about where you put your trust when the Ten comes up in relation to a question as to whether you can believe what a person is telling you or trust that a situation is stable. Well, if you look at the picture of the Ten of Swords, the card that's below the word outcome, it's a pretty clear answer of no. Now, with all these swords stabbed in his back, just keep in mind, though, whenever a door closes, another door opens. You're probably being guided to a situation that's better for you. So your outcome, Gemini, Five of Pentacles, clarified by Ten of Swords. Yeah. So the outcome is showing that your person wants to come together and rejoice and celebrate with you, so that you two can be happy again. They wanna get with you, Gemini. But the outcome is showing that you could start to feel that the connection is no longer secure, or you're not trusting that it's a stable connection. Yeah, whatever this person did or said to you, it's really got you feeling some kind of way. Yeah, you don't trust the person, or you don't trust the connection anymore with this Ten of Swords here. You're feeling insecure, could be about yourself, or you're feeling that the connection is not secure anymore. This person wants to come together with you and maybe continue celebrating the rest of the, or celebrating the new year. But you can't help but be judgmental, and you're just having a hard time forgiving what happened, what they said, or what they did. And it just looks like you're going cold, really cold on this person with the Emperor. Yeah. But this person, it seems like they were really good at putting in a lot of energy and effort just to make the relationship work, but something happened. So you're starting to feel some kind of way. Yeah. So that's the reading that I have for you, Gemini. I hope you enjoyed the reading. I hope it resonated. As you know, general readings, they do not always resonate with everyone. Then again, if you like the reading, please comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell. That way you'll be notified when I post my next reading. I will put a link below of the extended of this reading where I'll go over how you both feel about the situation. What's in the near future for the two of you? How you see yourself, best case scenario, and what will happen between the two of you in the next few weeks? There's also a link below for personal readings if you'd like to try one of those. So Gemini, thank you so much for watching. I hope all of you are doing well and staying safe during this crazy virus season. Hang in there, it's gonna pass. We'll all get through this, so stay strong, take good care, come back and join me for the next Gemini reading, just in case this did not resonate. Maybe the next reading will. Also, keep in mind when you get the readings, the roles of the people can be switched. Yes, they can. Meaning you could be them or they could be you. And if you're not dealing with anyone romantically, the other person could actually be a friend, family member, coworker, or maybe even a situation. So just take the readings for however it resonates, because once again, these are general readings. They are not personal readings. So Joe and I can never say it enough. I thank you so much for watching. I hope that you had a wonderful holiday. I'm wishing you the very, very best for the new year, 2021. I hope to see you at the next reading. I hope you have a great day. And take care.